All right, picking up season two of the Fields of Dreams League at July 5th. So plan on doing a few games. I've got four earmarked to cover. One of them here on the 4th, and then three games on the 5th to highlight. Let's see who's going to join us live. Who's going to be the first one into the live broadcast today to win the honorary bobblehead? We shall see. But the one game I'm going to cover, I've got some good matchups. We can see we've got Liverpool, Berlin, Hagerstown locked in a good race in the Earth Division. My team, I'm seven back now. I'm still chasing down, trying to get close to Chicos, who's off to a hot start. Lancaster, only two games behind Canada, and a three-way race over in the Water Division with Tampa Bay, Mid-Michigan, and Hadley Lake. So some real good teams. And listening from 35,000 feet is Bernie. And Bernie, I know I've been out of, missed it. I'm not sure where your destination is, but have a great flight. And isn't technology amazing when you can tune into a league game while flying? Here we go. Taking a look at the games on the 5th. The one I'm going to highlight here, special request after I heard Mike Silva talking about some of his misfortune in some past games, is getting San Francisco into the mix. And we've got San Francisco at the Upcountry Degens. Oh, okay, good. San Jose. Have a good visit, Bernie. So I'm going to fire up the first game here. It's going to be San Francisco at Degens. Let's get this one set up. And it looks like we've got that. Let's get rolling. Dan Kovaleski and Addie Joss. A couple of vintage players. Woo-hoo, Big Clue. Let me see. I've got this sideways view stadium on here. I may switch it up. Let's see how this goes. Play a little three-quarter here. Play a little three-quarter screen here on this field. And what do we have? We have a ground out here to Hernandez at first. And here is Jorge Posada stepping up. The pitch. And Posada ropes one into left center field. This view is killing me. Well, let's switch over to one of Mike's stadiums. There we go. Now we've got the view I like. And here we go. Here's Tris Speaker up. Speaker pops this one up. Lajoie looks like he's going over into foul territory. And he'll make the catch. Puts it away two down for Alex Rodriguez. Interesting, the Nooches team, San Francisco here, has some key players that are going to get better as the years go on. And that's Derek Jeter and A-Rod. And here's A-Rod, sends this one back to the wall. The man ram back there gets it, but not before a run scores. And that'll be a double for Rodriguez, and that'll score the first run of the game, bringing up Mo Vaughn. And Vaughn sends this one deep. I think it's out of here. It is, and San Francisco lighten up Addie Joss. I don't know. Mike's in the house to see this. He's probably like, damn it. I told you I didn't want to watch a game with my team playing. But I thought, well, hey, let's see what they got. Let me turn this one to full screen. I'm just realizing. There we go. Now I can see the big screen I'm used to. So here we go. So 3-0 lead here. Two down. Joss trying to get out of this first inning. And this will be a single through to the left. Oh, no, he's going to stretch it into two. And there's a double. And this is the inning that just won't end for Addy Joss. What the heck is going on here? And Matsui pops this one up behind the plate. Should stay in. Molina should make an easy out. He does, and that ends the top of the first. And here comes the home team, the D-Gens, sending up Hornsby, Hernandez, and Holmes. And Hornsby in the leadoff spot.
Ball four.
Draws a walk. Keith Hernandez. What's he doing? Hornsby's off and running. And gets caught stealing. Maybe it's a good thing Mike isn't in here watching this right now. Here's Keith Hernandez. Hernandez sends this one out into right field. Off the wall. In with a double. His 28th double of the season. He's a double machine. I think he had 47 in real life. Mike, you just got in. Addy Joss gave up 3 runs in the first, and Hornsby got thrown out stealing for you in the bottom, so. Let's see if this hometown D-Gens can do something. Tommy Holmes sends this one out of here. So, hey, no lead is safe in this league, and the D-Gens pull within one, get 2 of those runs back. Tommy Holmes coming through. Here's Big Poppy.
Strike 3.
And he strikes out. Here's Manny, left fielder today. Hits this one hard out to left. Matsui at the wall. Looks like he might have had a jump for that one, and that'll end the first, 3-2. This might not be a pitcher's duel. Andre Dawson strikes out. Here's Robinson Cano, the number 9 hitter. Pretty good 9 hitter. Ground ball to Lajoie, over to Hernandez in time. Jeter with the grounder. Lowell up with the throw. He gets him. We'll head to the bottom of the second. Here's Lajoie batting down in the 6th slot.
Strike 3!
And Kovaleski gets him on the inside corner there. Mike Lowell down the right field line. Andre Dawson tracks it down. 2 down. And here's Vada Pinson. Vada. Dawson, another play on the line, makes a catch. And we played 3-2 game for Jorge. Welcome in, everybody. We got Dwayne Martz here. David Lando, buckshot. Bernie, high up into the air, listening to this broadcast. Mike Silva in. Big clues here. Here's the pitch to Posada. Into center. Look at the range by Vada Pinson. He tracks that one down. One down for Tris Speaker. And Speaker's aboard with the single. Let's see if he'll be off and running. Doesn't look like a high steal chance here. A-Rod at bat. He's got 19 home runs on the year. Rodriguez to left. Ramirez makes the catch. Speaker holds. And that'll bring up Mo Vaughn. DH. And he hits a lazy pop-up. Legend Sports Universe in the house. As Al Red Sox would fan would say, check out that wonderful champ. And all those replays Legends has going on. Here is Molina. Ground ball to Harris. Kovaleski covers, and that will be an out. Here's Rogers Hornsby. Got thrown out stealing in the first inning. And Hornsby on the ground. Kovaleski's getting a lot of work having to cover first. He makes the play. Two away, and here is Keith Hernandez, batting 258. He's got 28 doubles. And the pitch, and he strikes out, and we've played three. 3-2 lead for the Safecrackers. Joe Harris, he'll strike out. So maybe Addie Joss has finally settled down after that rough first inning. We're going to see Joss in the league for the next several years. There's a fly out to Pinson. Some of these players we feature may not be keepers and may be gone, and others we might see for many years to come. And I think there's a few players here on the field we'll see. Hornsby, Lajoie, Hernandez in years to come. Andre Dawson may be another. A foul ball. And Dawson, boy, that was a frozen rope all the way over the left field wall, and we got a 4-2 lead just like that. Dawson smashed that one, and here's Cano, the number 9 hitter. Grounder to Lajoie, makes the throw. He's out. A run added, and here's Tommy Holmes, who's already homered in this game. Hit a two-run shot down the right field line. This time, Kovaleski gets him to pop up. And he makes the catch. Next American, yeah, the Tigers, Verlander and Cy Young going in Legends next game. So we've got a lot of sim baseball today and this weekend, and real baseball going on. So it's like the best of both worlds this time of year. Here's Big Poppy. Strikes out. Here's Manny Ramirez, 294 on the year. Not getting a lot of playing time. Only 17 at-bats in this replay. Sends it to center. Tris Speaker with great range gets the out. And we played 4-2. And here's Derek Jeter. Key strikeout. Jorge Posada. Slow roller. Lajoie in time. Two down. And here's Tris Speaker. Lined a single his last time up. And Joss retires the side. So here we go. Bottom of the fifth. Looking to get those two runs back. Got the number 6 hitter, Nap Lajoie, up. And he sends this one back up the middle. Drops in for a hit. Brings up third baseman Mike Lowell. Lajoie off and running, and he swipes a bag, so stolen base number 6 for him. Puts a runner in scoring position, no out. And Lowell comes through, not sure this is going to score. No, Lajoie will hold. Hard hit ball, runners on the corners, no out. Center fielder Vada Pinson up. Ooh, foul ball. I think. Big foul territory here at Braves Field. Rodriguez, oh my gosh, the drama. Is he going to get it? No. Here's Pinson. Pinson steps in. Hard hit to Rodriguez. They're going to try to turn two. They won't be in time. Lajoie scores, and we got a 4-3 game. Will Mike Silva get to see his upcountry D-gens win a game? Pinson off and running. And he's safe. Boy, aggressive on the base paths. The D-gens are. Looking to claw back into it this inning. And that'll be the second out. And here's Hornsby. It's walked and grounded out. See if he can get that tying run home. Hard hit. Kovaleski snags it. Tosses to Harris. That'll end the threat. But one run comes in, and it's a close game. 4-3 as we go to the top of the sixth. And here is A-Rod. Flies out to left. Brings up Mo Vaughn. DH for the Safe Crackers. Joss gets a key strikeout. So Joe Harris, the first baseman. Hornsby playing short. Gets him. Another chance for the D-Gens here. And Hernandez draws a walk. Tommy Holmes. Hit that big home run. Bottom of the first. This one's hard hit. Out to left. Going to be off the wall. Holmes comes through with his bat again. Ties the game up 4-4 with a double. So Tommy Holmes playing some good baseball today. We got a tie game. Uh-oh. Posada wants to get the signs right. And, oh, they decide to walk Big Poppy. Set up a double play with Manny Ramirez coming. I don't know about that. They must know what they're doing. Ramirez in the air. Be a fly out to left. Runners hold. Brings up Lajoie with one down. Lajoie out to deep center. Speaker with the play. Oh, Holmes is trying to tag. And he does. And the runner on second advances as well. A little aggressive today for the D-Gens. Here's Mike Lowell. Trying to break this tie. The pitch to Lowell. Lowell, grounder. Harris takes it himself. Ends a threat, but they tied it up. Got a heck of a game going here. See if Addy Joss can settle down. Keep this game tight. Oh, we've got that deep foul territory there. Come on. Lowell's going to make a dive for it. Oh, just misses it. Hideki hits this one out to right. Holmes puts it away. One down. Andre Dawson sends this one out to Pinson. Pinson makes the play. That's two down for Robinson Cano, who sends this one all the way down the left field line to the wall. Ramirez tracks it down. Gets it into Hornsby, so Cano is in the second with a two-out double. And that brings up Derek Jeter, the leadoff hitter. And he makes the catch. Robert from RJL Network is in the house. Welcome. Let me hear you, as Aaron Reed would say. Got a 4-4 game here. Waiting for a haircut, RJL. Let's hope they do you up really good. Any special occasion, like a big date, or is it just a maintenance haircut? Two kinds. Vada Pinson steps in. Kovaleski, and Pinson draws a walk. The D-Gens looking to go up here. Bottom of the seventh. Yadier Molina. Pinson's moving, man. They've been aggressive on the base paths, and he swipes the base. 3-for-4 on stolen bases. And Pinson swiping third? And he does. Aggressive base running from Mike Silva's team here, and Pinson steals two. They want that go-ahead run. Here's the pitch, Molina, grounder, and they'll concede it. They go ahead 5-4, get the play at first. Aggressive base running today. Carlos Yaz in the house. Welcome. Hornsby to Rodriguez. Rodriguez with the throw. in time. Two down for Keith Hernandez. He's doubled and walked today. And that'll end the threat. Going to the top of the eighth. Now 5-4 lead for the home team. Posada. Easy play for Lajoie. One away. Brings up center fielder Tris Speaker. Flies to Pinson. Pinson makes the catch. Two down. So Joss looking pretty tough the last three innings. And I just jinxed him as Rodriguez gets a two-out single. Bringing up Mo Vaughn. And Vaughn. Back to Holmes. Holmes with the play. Bottom of the eighth now. Tommy Holmes having a big day. He's doubled, hit a two-run homer. Had some key hits. This time, Dawson comes in on that. Won't drop in. He makes the play. One down. And Ortiz all the way to the wall. He's in there with a double. Poor play in the outfield. And they will walk. Manny Ramirez set up the double play ball here. Here's Lajoie. Lajoie got a single. 1-for-3. And he lines this one straight to Jeter. Jeter makes the play. Two down for Mike Lowell. And Lowell comes through with the key hit. Will Big Poppy make it home? He just does. And he's safe. That's a 6-4 lead now. A little insurance run. Pinson steps in. Lines to Rodriguez. That'll end the inning. But we got a two-run lead going into the ninth. Eddie Joss still on the mound. Hasn't even reached 100 pitches yet. He's been pretty efficient today. Allow Brago Roth to pinch hit? Sure. We believe the computer manager here. Joss gets that first out. They're two outs away now. Hideki Matsui steps in. And this one's punched down the left field line all the way to the wall. Should be too easy. Ramirez tracks it down, gets it into Hornsby, and Matsui is in with a one-out double. Mike Silva wondering where Papelbon is. I don't know. He's in the bullpen. I don't know. Playing Candy Crush. Who knows? And Joss says, I don't need Papelbon. I got a two-run lead. Down to the final out. Here's Cano. Cano sends this one up the middle. It scores one run. And here's Addie Joss on the mound wanting to lock it down. Where is Jonathan Papelbon? The pitch to Jeter. Jeter sends this one into the outfield. Pinson says, we don't need no relief. Joss with a complete game win, 6-5. The home team gets a win. It sure didn't look like a win was going to happen when they gave up three runs in the first, but the D-gens clawed their way back for a key victory. What stands out in this game? Well, Tommy Holmes does, 2-for-4 with 3 RBIs, definitely the player of the game. And let's take a look at the fifth. What do we have going on here as far as games? Just checking the dates, making sure I'm on the right one. I've got another game here, which is going to be interesting on the 6th. Got three games. I mistakenly said the 5th, but there's three games on Sunday the 6th that I really want to highlight. So let's sim out the 5th and see what we get. We got Liverpool and Long Island. Really a tale of top and bottom here, right? Liverpool leading the division, Long Island at the bottom. And Long Island says, we don't care. Mike Flanagan gets a 3-1 win. Beats newly acquired Mort Cooper. And we've got Manchester and Hagerstown. Hagerstown only three games out. Manchester below 500. And Manchester comes out with a key win here, 10-7 over Hagerstown. Bob Horner with 3 for 4 with two home runs, though, in that game for the Hagerstown Braves. Vegas and Chicago. Chicago beats Vegas 4-3. Bill Hans moves to 6-10. Tex Eusen, who I believe will be headed out of town soon, takes the loss. And Roger Maris goes 3 for 4 with a home run. Lehigh and Chico's, that's my nemesis. And oh, Mike McCormick gets a key win here. Walker, 1 for 3 with a home run. So I'm pleasantly surprised there. To get any win I can get head to head with Chico's, I'll take. Dallas and Berlin. Berlin, 9-3 over Dallas. Dallas was leading the league early, and that looks like they dropped back to 500 ball right now. And Edmonton and Lancaster. Lancaster, 5-2 win. Lancaster talking about their pitching earlier. If anybody was tuned in to listen to Night Raven, give a great bit of information rundown on his pitching staff for this year and next year. Messersmith, a key part of that team. Cleveland and Teeville. Cleveland with the win. St. Pete and Tampa Bay. We're going to see St. Pete here on Sunday in a game against the Redshirts. And St. Pete, Fergie Jenkins comes away with the win, beats Tampa Bay, and Tampa Bay is in the running there for that division title. We watched the D-gen. So here's Edmonton and Lancaster, the nightcap. So we've got a couple double headers, I think, on Sunday that we'll be watching. And Lancaster beats Edmonton again in the nightcap. Bert Hooton comes away with the win. Florence and Hadley Lake. Hadley Lake, a game out. Florence in the fire division, the cellar dweller. Doesn't matter. A 10-inning game here as Florence takes Hadley Lake behind McCarver. Tim McCarver goes 4 for 5 and hits his third home run. So big win there for Florence. Amazing with a win over the Mid-Michigan Thrillers, who are also competing for the top of the water division. So Kurt Schilling gets a big win. And here is Canada at Carpathian. And let me see if I've got that. Okay, this is a game I'm going to do right now. I'm going to play this night game with Carpathian, Canada coming into town. Let's fire this one up. Get the computer lineup set, and away we go. Dizzy Trout against the Candyman. John Candelaria here as we tune in from old Forbes Field here. Canada. Eh? And here's a leadoff hit by Willie Wilson. Canada does what we'd expect. Probably looking to put up some offense. There goes Wilson. K-Line's going to pop this one up. Anybody in here cheering for Canada? Please let me know. I would think not. And there's a pop out. And here brings up Albert Pujols, the first baseman. Wilson's dying to get a steal, and he's going to. A terror on the base paths is 23rd. Let's see how this Canada team does against a lefty starter. Pass ball by Sanguian doesn't help. This probably will get the run home as deep fly ball to the track scores Wilson. Canada draws first blood. Simmons will fly out, but not after giving up or scoring a run. So here comes the Wolves. Cy Seymour gets a hit. He's always up there in the league leaders in batting average. And here is multi-position player Cesar Tovar. Grounder to Pujols. Pujols takes it himself. Easy out. Seymour goes to third. Rich Reese. Wilson back in center makes the catch. Guess what? We got a tie game. And here's Tony Oliva. And he strikes out. This is one of the oddest looking lineups I think I've seen for this Carpathian team. So, who knows? Yeah, Canada, boo. Wainer's in the lineup. Anyway. Candelaria's looking pretty good here. Here's Pablo Sandoval trying to keep this inning going, and looks like he'll pop out here to Leach. Leach makes the out. It doesn't look like the strongest offensive lineup from the Wolves, but Tommy Leach with his era-specific walk-up music. Sends this one out to center. Wilson and should track it down. Does. One down, and here is Phil Garner. He's going to get on board with a base hit. Leo Cardenas. Great shortstop. Ooh, Garner caught stealing. Ted Simmons fires down there, gets him. It's two down now. And we still got a 1-1 game. Here's Ken Boyer. This Canada team, pretty loaded team all the way around. And Willie Wilson. Let's see what his bat can do. Not much. And we'll head to bottom of three. Here's Manny Sanguian. Right around what we'd expect from him. Decent hitting catcher. He'll fly out to Smalley. Lloyd Wainer. Not the best numbers on the year here, but he's seeing some time for the Carpathian Wolves. He's regressing in his career, so we're going to see him get better and better as the years go on. And here's Seymour again up there in the top of the league in hitting, and he'll fly out to Calavito. So we played 3-1-1. Kaline on the ground. He'll get thrown out. Brings up Albert Pujols. 249 on the season, but he's knocked in 26 home runs. And when I make that 27, yes, we will. And Canada takes a 2-1 lead off a solo shot by Mr. Pujols. And here's Ted Simmons. Simmons flies to left. Tovar makes the catch. And that's two down. And Calavito pulls this one into the seats, it looks like. Tovar giving chase, but he's not going to get it. It's a 1-2 pitch. And Calavito hits this one down the left field line. Tovar drifting back. And Canada's power on display as this one sails across the street. And there we go. 3-1. Brings up utility man extraordinaire Ben Zobrist, and he makes the third out, so we're going to head to bottom of the four. See if the Wolves can get back into this. I don't think this team looks like they've got their best offense on the field, but maybe they do. One down. Here's Rich Reese. This will be a long ball out to center. Wilson makes the play.
or interfering with baseballs still in play will be requested to leave the stadium.
Little public service address. Please do not get on the field. Antonio Oliva, grounder. Smalley makes the grab, throws it. Is it in time? It is just in time. And we've played 3-1 Canada. Canada off and running. Sandoval's going to beat it out. What happened there? Error number 14 on Tommy Leach at third. As it gets under his glove, let Sandoval take second. And here's Ken Boyer, who will send a single into left. Sandoval rounds third, holds up. Runners at the corners, no out. Smalley out to center, should get the run home. It's a deep ball. Sandoval tags, scores 4-1. And Wilson keeps this rally going. Kaline. Oliva down the right field line. Is it? Yeah, he makes the catch. Boyer will. Nope, he's not going to tag. He's going to hold. Two down now for Pujols, who homered his last time up. And this one is up the middle. Cardenas makes a great play to first in time. And we've. See we got here 4-1 headed to the bottom of the fifth, and here's Tommy Leach trying to make up for that error. The pitch up the middle, and Leach going to stretch this into two. He'll make it. Foul ball. It is. Garner, hard hit. Smalley throws to first. Retires Garner. Cardenas. Smalley up with another one. Throws to first. Gets him. And this time Leach will move to third. Runner at third, two down. Here's the catcher, Manny Sanguian. And Trout gets him. Will Toole, welcome in, Will. Here's Ted Simmons. Candelaria gets it, throws to first. Rocky Colavito, going to pop this one up in the infield. Should be an easy play for Leach. I think last season I watched Leach drop a ball like this once. This time he catches it. Joe Murdy, welcome in. He's making a prediction. He's committed. His team, he says, is going to be completely different going from July to August. I look forward to seeing what that is, Joe. Here's Ben Zobrist with two down. Line shot to Cardenas. That'll end it. And we're headed to the bottom of the sixth. Home team Wolves looking to get some runs on the board. And Wainer will lead off. Cy Seymour steps in. High fly ball. Colavito will make the catch. Wainer holds. One down. Tovar. Oh, this one gets by Simmons. I don't know if they're going to score it. Score that, a wild pitch by Trout. Tovar. Trout gets him. So one down here. Reese looking to try to get that run home. And he draws a walk. Tying run steps to the plate. Antonio Oliva. I find it interesting, Oliva, his 10th at-bat right now, has not seen much action in this league. And Oliva strikes out in a key situation there, and that'll end the threat. And here is Kung Fu Panda himself. Oliva makes the grab, one down. Boyer out to left. Tovar puts it away. And Smalley will draw a walk. Yeah, Wilson with Smalley moving sends this one down the line. Tovar makes an incredible catch out there. Let me hear you. Here the Wolves are trying to get back into it. Leach will get aboard. This all the way to the wall. Should be two. It is his 10th double. Let's see if they can claw back in here. Phil Garner steps in. Grounder to Boyer. Boyer has a play to first. Leach will hold at second. Cardenas comes through with a hit. Leach around third. Going home, here's a throw, and he just does beat it. And we got a 4-2 game. There's a little life in the Wolves still. Manny Sanguian. Wilson back on the track, makes the catch. Two down, and here's Lloyd Wehner, the DH. Comes through, his second hit of the game, sends this one in to center. Cardenas takes third. Go ahead, run at the plate. Pitch. Up the middle. Smalley steps on second, makes the third out, but the Wolves get one run. We go to the top of the eighth, 4-2, Canada. Eight. K-line, the pop-up. A slow pop-up it is, and Garner makes the catch. Here's Pujols. Already got a home run today. He'll fly out to left. And Ted Simmons will fly out to center. So here we go, bottom of the eighth. Can the Wolves mount a comeback? Oh, we got the corners coming in on the infield. What's going on here with Tovar? Maybe they're worried about him trying to bunt his way on. He hits a dribbler, and Pujols still makes the play himself. Rich Reese. Out of play. Reese singles up the middle. He's aboard. And here is Oliva, 0-10 on the season, trying to get his first hit. And he grounds this one to Smalley, to Zobrist. Won't be a play to first. Two down. Leach, the tying run at the plate. Trying to keep Oliva close. Leach, into left. Calavito stands still, makes a catch, and that ends the threat. So here we go to the ninth. Candelaria is still on the mound. He's given up four runs on five hits. Not a bad outing, actually, in this league. And he gets the first out. Zobrist. Back goes Tovar. He makes the catch. So here's Sandoval. Flies out to left. So all in all, looks like Candelaria pitched a pretty decent game. But they did. Canada's been efficient, scored four runs on five hits. Trout still in there, and here is the last chance for the Wolves. Got their caps on backwards, and here's Phil Garner. And just what they wanted, got the leadoff man on. Leo Cardenas steps up. Be interesting to see if the computer does any... pinch hitting or whatever. Infield's guarding the line. Cardenas comes through. Looks like we got the first two aboard here. What do we think can happen? The pitch, Sanguian sends this one. So we've got a base hit. Will Garner try for home? He won't. Playing it cautious, we've got no out. Bases loaded, and here is Lloyd Wehner. Infield playing in halfway. The pitch to Wehner. Wehner on the ground. Smalley's charging it. He's going to make a play at the plate, and not in time. Runners all safe. And we got a 4-3 game. No out. Bases still loaded. And I don't believe Sean's here to have this drama impact him. It'd be an anxiety attack would be going on right now. Infield comes in. Seymour, the pitch. He grounds this one. Pujols has it. Infield in. The play to the plate. In time. Oh, man. A double play. Great play by Pujols, who's a gold glove over there. Gets the force at home. Back to first in time, and we are down now to the last out, and Cesar Tovar will step in. Here's the pitch. Tovar up the middle. One runs home. Will Wehner go? He does, and Tovar with a walk-off single brings two runners home. Hey, Mike in the truck. Welcome, man. And just like that, the Wolves end up beating Canada. What a game. A walk-off single. Look at Trout. He had minus-minus stuff and still went the distance. Both pitchers do. Candelaria ends up with the win. What a comeback for the Wolves. Great game. So let's take a look at... the fifth is over. So now we're going to go into play July 6th games. And there is... definitely one here I want to focus on, and that's this Manchester at Liverpool. It's a doubleheader that day, so I'd like to play game one. So let's fire this one up. Get the computer lineups up. Christy Mathewson against Brandon Webb in game one. MV, I don't think MV's in the house. Big Clue is ready to see his team, no doubt. I think I'm going to option this one over to the other park image I've got here. Yeah, we'll play this one here. Anyway, here we go. Tony Gwynn leading things off for Manchester. 352 hitter. He's up there in the league leaders all the time as well. Let's see if Manchester can do anything against this hot Liverpool team. Knight Ravens cheering on Liverpool. Liverpool playing tough.
Strike three.
And a 1-2-3 inning for Christy Mathews. Here's Liverpool's batters coming up. Torrey Hunter in center. Clark's the DH, and Rusty Greer. Not the best offensive lineup I've ever seen for Liverpool, but I'll tell you what, they're getting it done. And error by Ken Keltner. Now, isn't that one of MV's favorite players on his team? Third baseman Keltner with a key error there. Let's Hunter take second. And here is the DH, Will Clark. Clark comes through with a key hit. Up. Hunter will hold. I really wish MV would tune in here. I'd love to have him watch this game live. The banter between him and Big Clue would be great. Here's Rusty Greer. Sends this one out to right center, and it's gone. Wow, wow, wow. Boom. And just like that, Liverpool's out to a 3-0 lead. Yeah, Banter is one word for it. Yep, you bet. Here's Joey Votto, first baseman. Pops up to Bip Roberts. The drama. Look at this fly ball. Will it get to the seats? No. Roberts makes a play. Nice catch. One down. Yeah. You look at it and you're like, this isn't really the best offense, but look what. Look what they're doing. They're putting up some offensive numbers here. And here's the pitch. Votto strikes out. Joe Morgan. Ooh, beats it out. Brings up Whitey Kurowski. Morgan's off and running as expected and steals second. His 24th stolen base of the year. Yeah, everybody on MV's team is his favorite. Except Cy Young, he'll never have again. And here comes Morgan. They're going to make a throw to the plate, and Morgan beats it, and that's the fourth run this inning as Kurowski comes through with a key hit, bringing up catcher Mike Piazza. Roberts over to Chapman. They turn two just when they needed it, but Liverpool out to a 4-0 advantage. Let's see if these bats can get back into it for Manchester. Manchester's got Stan Musial, probably their core batter for many years to come on this team, along with Tony Gwynn. And that'll end that threat. So see if Liverpool can add some runs to it. Here's Barry Larkin. Jackie Jensen. Scour into Webb, and here is Torrey Hunter, the center fielder, known as Spider-Man. And we've played 4-0. Here's Mathewson, looking pretty good today. On the year, Mathewson's 15-9. He struck out 178. I wouldn't expect him to have a tough time with this feeble Manchester lineup. But we'll see. Anything can happen in a given day. Ooh, trying to steal a base. Piazza, not known for his defense, guns him out, and there's one down. That'll help Mathewson out a little. Yeah, you're right. I've already been thinking about it, Buckshot. In fact, I may zoom it to about the 6th is what I'm thinking, because that is a fun option. I thought Manchester might put up a fight, but they're very feeble. I don't know how else to say it. Let's see what we got. Quick zoom. How about we go to the end of the 6th? See what we get. And we're right back where we were, right? It's a 6-1 lead here for the baseball club. And let's go back to... Start reducing my commentary and just hitting some damn buttons here and see what we get. Oh, Manchester's got a key hit here. Will Jacobson go for two? Jacobson entered the game here since the start and leads off with a double. So maybe there's a chance for this team. Musial comes through with the hit. Jacobson around third. He will hold. And Bip Roberts gets thrown out. They'll concede the run, and Manchester gets their second run on the board. That zoom feature is something we could use a little bit more of and get more games in and move some things along, no doubt. Here's Ken Keltner. All he's done today is make an error. I don't think he's done anything else. And that's a flyout. And I know MV would say, when Sotherin comes in, it's a bad sign. Well, he's in. Let me go heat up my coffee while we... And let's continue this game. I'm just getting a little of my coffee heated up here. Bear with me a moment while we've got a 6-2 game here. Hoping to see a better one, but you know what? In this league, no game is really over. We've had some big comebacks. Very interesting games. But with Mathewson on the mound, it's quite a challenge to come back here for Manchester. Let's see if they can add more runs, Liverpool, that is. Musial playing left, makes the catch. DH Will Clark, and he's aboard with the single. Will the thrill. Rusty Greer, kind of an underrated, under-the-radar type of person, right? He's batting 306. Had a key home run in this game already. Pops up behind Downing. I heard, saw a news article on Downing here that he's, is he being inducted into the Angels Hall of Fame or something like that? And he makes the catch, two down. Here's Joey Votto. And Votto smokes one into the seats, and we got an 8-2 ball game. And let's bring out that zoom feature. How about the end of the eighth? Let's see what we got. And just like that, let's get this set back up here on play. We're good. And Mathewson's still on the mound. This is Manchester's last attempt. Baby Doll Jacobson in. Musial. Can he do something? Well, he keeps it alive. He's aboard with a single. Bip Roberts, he keeps it alive. There's a life left in this thing. Uh-oh, Piazza wants to check with Mathewson. Hey, don't let these guys catch up. And Mathewson says, yep, let's send him down. So here's Keltner. Made an error, and he's 0-3. I'm not sure why MV likes this guy. He's batting 203 for him with 11 homers, and he's made quite a few errors. So I'm really not sure what's appealing. Here's the pitch. And Keltner will make the last out of the game, and Mathewson gets another win. 8-2. Take a look at the pitchers. Webb gets beat up on. Southern comes in and hits, but only got gave up two runs out of that and goes to 16-9 on the season. So what other game was I going to feature? Ah, yes. Joe, you're in. We're going to watch your St. Pete Sharks in action against the Redshirts. And here we go. We'll get to see Manchester-Liverpool a little later. They have the nightcap here, so. Chicago at St. Pete. We are in Comiskey. What do we got? Andy Bennis against Eric Bedard. A couple more modern pitchers here.
Play ball!
And here we are at Comiskey. Let me take the size down a little bit on the oh gosh, we've got this thing all misaligned here. How about we get the pitcher where he belongs? And do we have the right field? No, yeah, we got him pretty good. So here's Bobby Richardson leading it off for the Redshirts. And Bobby Richardson's going to have a leadoff double at least. Here's the throw in. Is he safe? He is, just ahead of the throw. And a leadoff double. And here's Edgar Martinez. I think Edgar Martinez is making a move, if I'm not mistaken, here at the next trade deadline. And Martinez drops a bunt. Are you kidding me? Look at that. Gets Richardson to third, playing some small ball. And that'll bring up Dave Winfield. What's going on with that David Landau and his redshirt team here? Mickey Mantle, cleanup hitter, two down, runner at third. And Mantle hits this one hard. And Page makes the catch. Is this Eddie Collins? Yeah, we got Eddie Collins in the game leading off for St. Pete. And here's Shoeless Joe. Jackson strikes out. Aubrey Huff lines to center. So we've played one. No score. Brings up Larry Chipper Jones. A lot of these players on Chicago I seem to remember from other people's teams, like Jones, Mantle, Marte. Is there anybody left that originally started with the Sharks? Or with the, what are they? The Red Shirts. Who knows? Here's Rico Cardi. Wes Parker. And Wes Parker is aboard. Brings up catcher Chris Hoyles. Hoyles hits this one out in the left. Oh, boy, it's going back. Chris Hoyles with the two-run shot. Yeah, boy, two-run homer by Chris Hoyles, 473-footer. And here comes a guy that's well-traveled this season, was on my team for a while, Dave Concepcion. 10-rated shortstop. Let's see if he can do something with the bat. He's batting down to the bottom of the order. He's going to ground out. Chris Hoyles, yeah. And that ends it. But here comes St. Pete. Don't sleep on St. Pete. They've got some bats in this lineup with Canseco. We saw Joe Jackson a little bit earlier. Here's Jose. Jose, can you see? And he will. Strikeout, throw out right there. And Tim Wallach goes down. Here's Marty Marion. Great shortstop. Pops this one up. Hoyle's giving chase. It's going to get into the seats, I think. It does. And here's Marty Marion again. Steps in with a 1-2 count, and he will strike down, strike out. So we've got two innings down. 2-0, Chicago. And Bobby Richardson, double number two. Back-to-back doubles for him today. And leadoff runner on again. And Bedard walks Martinez. So Bedard getting himself into a little bit of a trouble here with Dave Winfield and Mantle due up. Winfield down the left field line. Mitchell Page puts it away. One down. And here's Mickey Mantle. Only batting 248 on the season. Not one of his better years. This is 1960 Mickey Mantle. And just when I say that, he comes through with a hit. Richardson holds up. Here's the pitch to Chipper. Chipper pops it up behind the plate. Ray Schalk. It's floating down like a marshmallow. Makes the catch. Two down. And here's Rico Cardi. And Cardi strikes out. Man, squandered. A bases-loaded situation there and couldn't get any more runs home. So Bedard gets himself out of his own jam. And here's Mitchell Page, batting 174 on the season. And he's now batting a little less than 174. Ray Schalk. Great catcher. He flies out to Winfield as well. That's two down for the Sharks. And center fielder Omar Moreno batting a whopping 149.
Strike three.
And he strikes out. Here's Wes Parker. Got a hit his last time up. This time he's going to ground to Huff. Huff takes it himself. the throw to Huff. Yeah, Bernie's saying always sacrifice in the early innings. Yeah, and it's interesting. I think we did was able to find some research on just how evenly distributed sacrifices are across all the innings. In fact, it was a little eye-opening. Here's Concepcion, the number 9 hitter. Out to center, and that will be an out. Brings up Eddie Collins. Collins out to Mantle. He makes the catch. Great play by Mantle. Great play number 15, if you track those kind of things. If you don't, the game does it for you, so that's always fun. Here's Shoeless Joe. Shoeless Joe out to Winfield, and he puts it away. So here's Andy Benes. Benes pitching a really good game. Huff lines it to Richardson, who makes the catch. This redshirt manager's got to be happy seeing this team in action. And Richardson almost beat that out. Would have been his third hit. Edgar Martinez steps in, strikes out, and here's Dave Winfield. And he's aboard. Oh, Winfield off and running, makes a turn aggressive, and he gets his 22nd double of the year. And puts a runner in scoring position for the Mick. And Mantle down the left field line in the seats. A two-out double by Winfield, followed by a two-run shot by Mantle, and this is a 4-0 game now. I know David's got to be happy to see that kind of output from Mickey. And Chipper Jones on the ground. Marty Marion with the throw in time, and that'll end it. So here's Benes back on the mound. Sharks are hitless. Thinking we get through this inning, I think by the fifth inning, if there is a no-hitter, they'll throw the warning up. But Benes is pitching really good ball right now. Here's Tim Wallach. Cardi makes the catch, two down, and Marty Marion steps in. And he puts this on the ground to Jones. Jones with the throw. That will be the third out. Oh, it's a perfect game alert. Perfect game alert. I'm not sure we've had a perfect game this season. Or ever. I'm not sure. Let's see. Maybe that's a box score we can look up. High fly in. Infield pop-up here for Cardi. Oh, one. Cool. Do you know who threw it, Mike? Was it last year or this year? Oh, Blylevin. Cool. Here's Wes Parker. Parker goes down. Chris Hoyles with the big bat. He's a 222 hitter with three home runs, but we saw number three in this game. And he strikes down. So here's Benes back on the mound facing the 167 batting Mitchell Page. Mitchell says, I can't hit the ball. I'm going to try to bump my way on it. That won't even work. 179 hitting Ray Schalk. Mantle tracks this down. Brings up the 147 hitting Moreno. So not very many strong at-bats here. And we're through six. Perfect game still in order. Concepcion to Bedard. He'll range over and make it. Throw gets him. One down. And Bobby Richardson down the left field line. Page climbing the railing. Can't get there. And Richardson pops it up behind the plate. Will Schalk have room? We don't know. Probably not. Foul ball. And the slow roller. Huff to Bedard in time. Out two for Edgar Martinez. Martinez lifts this one out to left. Page makes the catch. And we are at the stretch with Eddie Collins due up. And let's play ball. Big thanks to Mike Silva, who created the wonderful uniforms and some of the logos here that you'll see in the game for our league. And here we go. Eddie Collins lines this one right to Concepcion, and he makes the play. So one away for Shoeless Joe. 265 on the season, one of the bright spots here for the bats for St. Pete. And he pops this one up. Looks like the shortstop, Dave Concepcion, will make the play. He does. Two down for Aubrey Huff, who's hitting 181. Wow. And he goes down swinging. So we got a perfect game through seven. And we got some low batting averages on this St. Pete team. And I know Joe said that some things are going to change. Starting in July, Jim Johnson comes in for Bedard, who's gassed. Have fun, Bernie. And that's out number one. So here's Mickey Mantle, hit that home run his last time up. Now he's batting from the other side of the plate, batting left-handed against her. Chipper Jones as well, and he strikes out. So here we go, bottom of the eighth. Canseco, 184. Man, I don't think I paid attention as I'm going down this lineup on the replay. A lot of sub-200 batters on St. Pete. Canseco hits this one hard. Winfield makes the catch. That'll bring up Tim Wallach. Fly ball. Rico Cardi makes the catch. Ben is pitching a gem. He'll be anxious to see if he's got any plus or plus-plus boost for the game. Marty Marion, 250, one of the better hitters on this team, I guess. And it looks like Cardi will make an easy play, and we got a perfect game alert through eight. So tune in to this last inning, see what happens. Chicago, no doubt, wouldn't mind some insurance runs because you never know. And Cardi gets aboard with the first at-bat here in the ninth. Johnson gets a strikeout. Now Johnson's showing red. He's getting close to his EPC. What'll happen? They're going to yank him, let him ride it out. Who knows? We got two down in the ninth. Concepcion. Now Ken Tatum, the great reliever, comes in and says, hey, let's not allow another run here. And Wallach with the play at third over to get the lead runner at second. And here we go, folks. A perfect game alert as we go into the bottom of the ninth. Bennis looks strong. Will the computer manager keep him in if it gets to a tired situation? Who knows? Mitchell Page steps in, and Page fouls this one off. What's Page batting now? I think we've watched his ERA. Yeah, he's a 160 hitter right now. Bennis on fire gets that strikeout. We're down to two outs, and here's Ray Schalk. Grounder to Parker. Two down. Bennis is dealing. Here's Omar Moreno. Ground ball to Concepcion. Concepcion over to first. Oh, I thought he was going to beat it out. What a play. The speed from Parker, and we just witnessed a perfect game in the Fields of Dream Season 2 here live as the Sharks and Andy Bennis just mow down. I'm sorry, the Red Shirts and Andy Bennis mow down the Sharks. What a game. That might be one of the worst hitting performances I've ever seen. I don't know what's going on, Joe. I bless you, whatever you can do, but that's some of the worst hitting lineup. No offense. As I'm about to offend you, that was some of the worst hitting as I looked at what people have been doing for your team in the season replay. I didn't know your team was that bad hitting, but wow. Wow, wow, wow. That's a good one. Fun game. What else do we have going on this day? So we've got Florence and Hadley Lake, and then we'll move into all the other night games here. Let's grab Florence and Hadley Lake. And Hadley Lake with a 9-0 shutout. Chief Bender comes through. Long Island and Berlin. Berlin up there 2.5 games behind Liverpool. And they're going to be a little bit farther behind. 3 games now because Long Island comes through with a 5-2 win behind Johan Santana. The D-Gens continue their what the D-Gens do. Ames loses, goes to 4-7. It's a close game, though, 3-1. Doc White gets his 10th victory. Amazing in Tampa Bay. Tampa Bay gets shut out by Cole Hamels as the Amazing Kitsunes come through with a 2-0 win. And Tampa Bay and Mid-Michigan are locked in a tie and Hadley Lake a half game out. So that water division, it seems like it's always neck and neck in all of our replays when we're simming out to see what's going to happen. Lehigh, I'm at T-ville. So, Carlos, I know you're in here. See what happened. Oh, Carlos, you're here to witness an ass-kicking as Randy Johnson mows down my team 12-2. Hagerstown, 10-3 over Dallas. Lancaster, 5-2 over Edmonton. That seems to be a familiar Edmonton score, 5-2 losses to Lancaster. The nightcap here for Liverpool and Manchester. Liverpool, the smackdown continues as they win the doubleheader. McLean this time gets a key win over Whitey Ford. Manchester really looks like they're headed into a bad direction. So here is Chico's. I'd like to see them lose. I'm just saying. Yay! Thank God Chico's loses when I lose, because if they win when I lose, I'll never catch them this year. San Francisco and Nooch come through with the 10-7 win. And here's Vegas in Mid-Michigan. And Vegas squeaks by in a 14-inning game. Bonds goes 3-for-5 with his 18th home run. So that gets us up to the 7th. And I think I'm going to stop right here. We're going to have interesting. St. Pete and Chicago are going to have 2 more games here. They're going to have a doubleheader. Dallas and Hagerstown will have a doubleheader on Monday. Interesting, interesting, interesting. If I would have lost, I'd have thrown a beer towards the broadcaster's booth. Yeah, that'll be great. And hey, if you're here, Carlos, I'll fire up me and you, our game, if you'd like to see it. Let's fire ours up and see what happens with the night game. So here's Chicago and St. Pete. Chicago with the win. Tampa Bay with the win over Amazing. Lancaster, and Lancaster continues the beatdown on Edmonton. Yes, we are keeping through the encyclopedia. At the end of every season, we'll have our own league encyclopedia compiled, Carlos, so you bet. Chicago gets St. Pete again. Hagerstown over Dallas. Liverpool over Manchester. Hadley Lake over Florence. Berlin best Long Island. What about these D-Gens? Cleveland beats the D-Gens. And let's fire it up. And then I'll zip up this file after I complete the 7th here. But I've got Carlos in here. Let's have some fun. Let's see our teams play here. Oh, boy. Yeah, what do we got here? Computer lineup. What are we going to see? Pat Hentgen and Mordecai Brown. So, can I demo it, please? If you mean like after this game, Mike. If you mean like the encyclopedia stuff, yeah, I'll do that on this broadcast if you want.
Play ball.
All right, let's see what we got. Pat Hentgen on the mound. Here's Craig Biggio stepping up. Grounder to Santo, up with the throw, in time. Cecil Cooper, I've got him batting DH, I think, maybe first base. Oh, he's aboard with a double. Yeah, I've got these two guys, I love them, Cooper and Bagwell.
Strike three.
And Pat Henkin. How's Henkin on the year? Henkin's 6-5 in the replay. George Foster steps up. Ron Santo with the throw to Olrud in time. That'll end it. Three Finger Brown, a guy I traded for, I'm hoping to have for the next several years. And here's Jose Cruz with the leadoff. Lancaster is in first place. I will look quick after this one and see what's going on over there, right? Roberto Alomar. Oh, there's that bunt drop. He's going to get that runner over to third with only one down. That's actually a pretty smart move to try to get a run. It's probably going to work. It will. And that run comes home, and the Blue Bolts take a 1-0 lead here. And that'll end it, but damage is done. So that sacrifice bunt maneuver seemed to work. Here's Petroselli. I don't know how this guy's going to do. Oh, Mays with the swipe. Pitch to Rico Petroselli. Petroselli walks. And here's a pitch to Caminiti. Caminiti comes through. Batting from the left side. He's a switch hitter. And 3-1, Lehigh. Dixie Walker, who I was been looking to put on the trading block here. He's got a great season this year and next year in 1946. Right fielder, I think he's a 6-rated right fielder with a great bat and on-base percentage. Bill Freehan getting the start today over Russell Martin, it appears. Cecil Cooper. Two out, runners at the corners. Here's Jeff Bagwell. And Bagwell comes through with a hit. This Bagwell's a beast with the on-base percentage and power. Foster down the line. Maglio makes the catch. Great play. And it's 4-1 Bolts as we go to bottom of the second, or 4-1 Lizards. It's Richie Ashburn aboard with a single. Mr. Cub, Ernie Banks. Yeah. Yeah, he's pumped up, him and Bagwell. Ah, Brown letting the first two runners aboard here. Here's Lou Brock, who will continuously keep getting better and better, assuming he's kept, which I think he will be. Mays makes a great play. Another great play by Mays. Always nice to have him out there in center. And he makes all three catches for that inning. And here we go. The pitch to Petroselli. Petroselli down the corner. Into the corner deep. Looks like it should be two bases. Mays goes to third. Petroselli gets a double. And Caminiti comes up again. Henkin gets a key strikeout. Walker in the center. Brock with the catch. Mays tag scores. That's 5-1. And here's Bill Freehan.
Strike three!
And he strikes out. Ordonez, two out, single to right. John Olrude up. And Olrude threw into left field, and now runners on the corners. Ashburn to Foster makes the catch. That ends the threat, and we've played three innings. Randy Jones coming in for T-Ville. And Cooper, I think that's his third hit. Cooper's doing pretty good today. Hit number three for sure. Pop up by Bagwell to third base. And he makes the catch. George Foster steps in, and Randy Jones come in, and oh, that's a strike. Foster on the ground. Santo over to first, should be in time. It is, and we're headed to the bottom of the fourth. I'm gonna do a quick zoom on this one, because I'm gonna have to wrap this up a little bit. Let's go end of the sixth on the zoom, see what we get. We've now got an 8-2 lead. Oh, Mike Timlin's coming in. The computer managers do its stuff here. And Petroselli puts this one in the seat. So Lizard's putting some runs on the board. Yeah, Carlos is like, maybe this wasn't the... I was hoping maybe we'd have a nice dramatic game or whatever we could enjoy, but this doesn't look like it. Santo to Alomar. Get through this inning and maybe we'll just send it out. Well, free hands double. They just keep pouring it on. Makes the catch. And Cooper into left field. Here comes Tony Castillo, bringing in some mop-up folks. There's a seventh inning stretch. I think it's time we end it. After the seventh inning stretch here, I'll hit the quick zoom. In fact, why even wait for that? Let's hit that zoom. Just go to setup and say, we've seen enough. Let's get this game over. 13-4. T-Ville or Lehigh put up a ton of runs in that one. So let's go to the other games on the 7th, and then I'll get this file zipped up and then walk through the encyclopedia from season one. We've got Hagerstown and Dallas with the second of their games. Hagerstown won the first, and they sweep them. They take both games of the doubleheader. Here is Carpathian in Canada. Let's take a look here. Lancaster, a half game ahead of Canada right now. So I'm assuming, Night Raven, you'd like to see the Wolves upset Canada. Let's see what happens. They do not, so now you are in a dead tie with Canada after Canada beats Carpathian 9-1. Chico's in San Francisco. Chico's with a 9-0 shutout of San Francisco, so they maintain a 6-game lead in the wind. And Vegas and Mid-Michigan, a 5-3 win for Mid-Michigan. And as we exit the games through the 7th, let's take a look at the standings. We got a dead tie with Lancaster and Canada. We got three teams all within a half game in the water. Berlin and Hagerstown 3.5 behind Liverpool, and I'm still 6 behind Chico's, which is they're out to a big start in the win division. Batting leaders, Cobb. Yep. Cy Young, leading candidate, Christy Mathewson. So familiar names that we've all come to know through this season. Yeah, in the misery. So here's what I'll show you about the encyclopedia that we have. So what happens is at the end of the season, which will be season 2, I'll then load in the stat. So you can have multiple, I think it's 50 encyclopedias. So if you look here, I've got, I think it's the Field of Dreams encyclopedia. Yeah. So this will have all the teams. So if we go back to the Field of Dreams encyclopedia, it has all season 1. The reason it says it has these four seasons is from season 1. These were all the seasons that we started with, that all the players could come from, right? So if we take a look at records, like we could look at player records. And you'll see this is from last year. So Norm Cash, it's all just got last year's data in here. But as we, at the end of season 2, we will bring in all the season 2 file, and it will load all of that stuff after the season is over, because it can also keep track of, I think, is it maybe even postseason stats, I think. Team records. So this show you all the record from last year, because we've only got the one season in there. I think you got to do a search for it. Let's say. Let's do pitching. Oh, this is player field. Oh, pitching. Shutouts, walks, hits. Batters faced, opportunities, save percentage. I'd have to dig around in here and take a look. Season, career, report. I know we can do it under box score search. Wow. Might have to figure out if we did a specific report. So we're looking at real replays. Oh, we could also look at playoffs. So this would have the playoffs from last year too. You could take a look at playoff specific things. You know what, Mike? I think I would have to go in here and I could create some reports. I think I'm going to figure out how we find it, because I know during a season, like if I pulled up season 1, we could look up box. You could go look for any parameter of a box score to find out, like, you know, any, like a max of 0 hits, and look it up that way. But under reports, it's got some pre-made ones right here, like batting, pitching, to complete games. But let's go. Yeah, it's just going to be hits on the season. I don't know if it's by, so player records.
shutouts, walks, hits. Yeah, I'm not seeing quality starts is there, runs, batter's face. I'm just not seeing like a no-hitter. But
I haven't dug around in here to look at all the different categories. We might be able to get it on another report. But the cool thing is the data is in there. It's just a matter of how do we find it. And then at the end of so if you are playing replays, let's say you started off in 1910 and you wanted to keep going, all you'd have to do is once your 1910 replay is over or whatever it is, you just go to your encyclopedia, create a name or whatever you want it to be, and then just go and import. So at the you can just keep adding into an encyclopedia that you want to name for a specific thing. So you could have multiple encyclopedias, and then as soon as you're done with the season, import all that data in there. So if you've already played 10, you could create one now. If you've like played from 1910 to 1920, you could go back and individually say, okay, let me import and bring those seasons in there. Encyclopedia names, you can come here. Like I've got one for Field of Dreams, but you got 50 slots. So you could just create a custom encyclopedia with the name and then figure out what you want to bring into it. And you just tell it, you know, add folder. So if I do a test one, let's pick one out here that's a test. Let's say we'll do number 50 and we'll call it test. So we'll make the test active. And let's see. Well, let me refresh it. Refresh it. Let me just back out and go back in. All right. Add folder. So I could go in here, years present. It's already got these in here. I could get rid of them. I can come over here and just pick any of these seasons that I've done and bring as many in as that I want. Well, you don't want to merge the season to date. It explicitly says in there to only completed seasons right here. So I'm like, if they put that in red letters, I'm like, yeah, wait till everything's done for a season and then bring it in versus in midstream. But yeah, so if you've got any replay ones, you could do it. And then, you know, do you want to add player data, add teams, right? Rebuild career encyclopedia, meaning you could bring in all seasons like historical up to that starting point if you wanted to include that. So there's a lot of options here, but the main thing is wait till you've replayed the seasons and then figure out how to build a book. It's basically take every file when it's done and then figure out what files you want to aggregate into one historical encyclopedia book. You could give it your own name. But if I'm looking, let's go to back to ours. Okay, there we go. Yeah, I think we got. Just trying to figure out why this doesn't. I could add all five of those. It seems like it's defaulting with the ones that are already in the encyclopedia. So if I wanted to test a complete one, I could go in there and delete these five seasons that I've got there by just saying delete found records. Yeah, I haven't played around with any of this stuff, so I'd be afraid to hit the button. Although you could rebuild it, rebuild career encyclopedia for test. Let's see. I don't know what the heck that means. I can always go back and replace it. team stats from the first one. Of course, the career leaders are going to pretty much be the same too, because we only got one season in there. Now, the thing that I've noticed is, if we look at players, for example, one thing it's not doing well, like if we go in here and look at Canada, for example, and we pull up player cards, you should see their real replay and then career overall. But you'll notice for some reason, since Canada is showing 1945, it's almost like how all the players that have the 1945 season will get their career showing what, you know, it's including what they did last year, but only that, meaning it's set to 1945 Briggs, so the 45 players will show their career stats, the other one don't. And I've noticed that with each team, and that's just something that Action's going to have to figure out because it's a brand new feature. So yeah, you can see it on their in-game cards. Our league, though, because it's bringing in multiple people from different years, it's not displaying correctly for some reason. So like here for you, for DGens, they're set to 1945 because of the field they're using. So everybody that's a 45 card, you can see it showing the proper career stats, meaning you're seeing the replay from this year, and then it's adding what Tommy Holmes did last year for you into that. So you're getting the ongoing career run. But if we go to Vada Pinson, we're not seeing it. So it'll be all your 1945 people. And I don't know why it is that way. Hagerstown, 1977. So when you look at Puckett, no career. But let's go to a 77 guy, Bob Horner. He's got career stats. So yeah, it seems to be whatever year the park is assigned to for the team, the career thing's bringing that in accurately, but it's not accounting for players that are like from all-time greats from different seasons. So that's something that I'm going to have to follow up with headquarters on as a beta tester, just to point that out. Because I agree with you. I think it's cool to see that on the player card. Now, if all the players come in, like if we looked at a existing season, I don't know if I've got one that's got. Let's take a look. Like say we go to 1976. And look at Singleton. As guaranteed, what happens is when they get a replay in there, you'll see career as well on that one, because they're all pointed to like the same year. So it's got to be something to do with that. So more to come on that. Yeah. That along with some other stuff that I've let him know, because we still had that one issue where I think a lot of what you're talking about, like with the report, sometimes it's how they're computing the roll-ups. It looks like the raw data is okay, but then their formulas they have to roll some of the stuff up is odd. Like we saw with the head-to-head issue in season one, where it didn't display the head-to-head games correctly. Let's see what we got here. Let's see how it's doing this way. So reports, league, team versus team chart. So let's take a look at this. So it's doing something like it did last year, where Manchester's is jacked up. You can just tell here, like they haven't played 33 games against Dallas. And I sent that bug in as well. Yeah, and how it handles traded players. But the other thing too is if you trade players, now that once they've got at-bats with the team, you got to make sure when you send them that you don't zero their stats out. Yeah, and you're right. We're gonna do stuff in this league with multiple trades that never happened in real life. We're going to test the system in ways probably no other league would ever test and find out things with as much trading as we're doing. So we may break some things along the way and find bugs that nobody knew about. So I'm going to zip This, call it to July 7. Well, let's put the zip. Thanks, everybody, for hopping on and letting me run some games today. It was fun. And I'll post this file soon, and I'm going to call it a day. But, hey, hopefully somebody picks it up, and I'll see.